Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Gulfstream. Today, Ron Nicoletti, along with Acacia Courtney, is a Friday afternoon. We're starting the day with a fast main track and a firm turf course. And let's see, it's Friday. So what happens today? Oh, I remember. Beat the expert. And I'm the guy that's up today. So don't forget, you got about 50 minutes or there, 55 minutes to play. It's absolutely free to play.
Yes, it is. And it's always a lot of fun. Ron's got his game face on. Don't let that smile fool you in that picture. He is ready to roll. You can go to our Facebook page or go to the Gulfstream Park website. It's under contest. Don't forget to use hashtag beat the expert. Let us know that you're playing. And Friday's always a lot of fun. We got the Stronach 5 today, too.
Yeah, but that $100,000 guarantee with only the 12% takeout. Occasionally, I'll have a ticket a little later on. We pooled our resources today. $4 each, I think we went
in. Yeah, we went with a $108 ticket, so still pretty affordable, that $1 minimum, just a 12% takeout, though. We've seen it pay off really, really well, but it should be a fun Friday of racing and a great weekend coming up as well.
Yeah, we got a nice weekend coming up with 13 races tomorrow and 12 on Sunday, and we got the Inside Information
Grade
2 on Saturday. Really nice race. We'll see how that plays out, but let's show you the menu we have today for you as far as the racing, the betting goes. And a pretty good wagering menu today, because you're going to see we got an early pick 5. Acacia's going to have a ticket. And we got the super high 5. Oh, there it is. The Rainbow 6. $1.5 million.
Boy, that's not too bad. I think I would take that. $1.5 million. It starts in race 5 today on this 10-race card. It started race 5 yesterday as well. And there were no singles heading into the final leg. So we'll see if that carries on. It was a relatively formful day yesterday. Quite a few favorites winning. So that'll be a big telltale sign today for Ronnie being beat the expert.
Yeah, and you know, the 20-cent wager, you can take it all down. We're trying to see if it can last the Florida Derby. Just about 10 more cards or something there about. It would be $20 million. But you have a chance to take it down today. So we're taking care of all that early business. And as we mentioned at the top, when you saw the wagering menu, we have a couple of pick fives today. And you have an early pick 5 ticket.
I do. We start with a pretty competitive field here. I'm using the number 2 is currently a 4-5, very early in the wagering, but a little bit of a rematch here between He's a Kitten and Rumson Rally, who faced each other on February 1st, and we'll take a look at that race in just a little bit. Going too deep as well in race number 2, I like Aaliyah's Story on the drop. I actually like this horse all along, though. Pretty key scratch of the morning line favorite and pretty overdriven for Kathleen O'Connell. In race number 3, too deep, and then going to spread in race 4. I just kind of took this race as a lot of wild cards. You've got drop-down runners, you've got layoff runners, trainer changes. There's just a lot going on, and I could have even pressed all in that race. Fifth race, I'm using the 3 SPAC and the 10 General June. I've got a couple of good barns in the mix there, and hopefully that'll get me home for $32.
$32 ticket, and I hate to say it, but we're pretty much in agreement through a couple of those races.
We even have the same long shot today.
Yeah, I don't know. That we'll talk about that Modern Tale, I believe, in race number 9.
Yeah.
And I knew she copied me, but that's a story for later on. So let's look at, you mentioned you're going to show the race between, Rumson Rally and He's a Kitten. I did go with Rumson Rally over He's a Kitten. Let's see that race.
Yes.
Tell me why.
Who'd you pick?
Rumson Rally.
I did too. So, yeah. Well, as we look at this race, He's a Kitten is the number 7 forwardly placed. Rumson Rally, the 5 along the rail. We pick it up from the quarter pole. This is actually 2 starts back from Rumson Rally, but see, the 5 is just blocked in. He's really keen to go, has absolutely no place to go. I think He's a Kitten had the easier trip in here going out to the front. And Rumson Rally re-rallying inside. He really lived up to his name. When you have a horse that has his momentum shut off like that and doesn't have a chance to run, it's pretty rare for them to come back and down inside like he did. I thought it was a very game effort.
Yeah, and you know, his performance 2 starts back was a really good race. So for all the reasons you just shown, that's why I did go with Rumson Rally. But as you mentioned, current 4-5 favorite is the number 2. He's a Kitten, who's another going to drop to the 20 level today in racing without the blinkers this afternoon. Surrendered that late lead that you saw right there. Finished a neck behind Rumson Rally last time out.
And he's been consistent. He has a little bit more speed than Rumson Rally does, and that really could be the great equalizer in here. But I think you and I both in the camp of thinking Rumson Rally ran a little bit of the better race. And then it looks like it's pretty wide open from there on out. The number 6, Super Warrior, I thought could be a little bit interesting getting the blinkers on.
Well, let's go to race number two. And this one, 6 furlongs, claimers, fillies, and mares, 4 and up, non-winners of 3 and life, for a race since September 30th. And as you mentioned when you were showing your ticket, big scratch in here of the number 4, Pretty Overdriven. And you did go with this horse you said you like, mm-hmm. Aaliyah's Story, on top of a ticket has a tag sliced in half.
Yeah, she does. It's a big drop for this filly, for Elizabeth Dobles. Moved back to this barn last time out and ran a fine race, I thought, just against significantly tougher. So getting a big drop today, and Elizabeth, the trainer of our long shot modern tale a little bit later on. So hopefully it's a big day for this barn. But I thought that this filly was tactical. Now she might have a little bit tougher because one of the main pace scratched out with Pretty Overdriven. I thought that horse in Flashing Diamond would go with Aaliyah's Story just sitting, but hopefully she'll still get a good trip.
And that's why I originally had Flashing Diamond on top, and I like it even better now because of the scratch of Pretty Overdriven. This one is a 6-time winner, making her first start. She dueled for lead. She weakened to finish 6th. It was behind a Next Out Stakes winner called Shanghai Starlet, against state bred optional claimers. That was last July. That is the key there. But this one is the speed of the speed, Tyler Gaffleon on top. If this horse come back and run, I think this horse has the perfect pace scenario set up for her today, this afternoon, for Flashing Diamond. Aaliyah's Story on paper, recency is the one to beat.
I think so too, and that was the biggest question with Flashing Diamond, just off the layoff, but comes back in a sprint distance, and I think that she is really aided by the scratch of Pretty Overdriven.
And the number 7, Fergalicious, was really sharp here last spring. Hasn't been seen since Gulfstream West.
Yeah, it's been a little bit of a tricky 2018 for this horse, who was in really, really good form. Then it was a layoff from June to October, and then October till now. So definitely been a bit tricky for this mare, but she's got some races on the go back to run to.
Well, let's flip the page, go to race number 3. It's a mile on the turf. These are claimers, 3 and up, non-winners of 2 and life, $16,000, excuse me. And once again, we're in agreement with the number 9, Coniston. Wheeling back after breaking from an outside post last time out, post 11. Goes up, duels for the lead, and fades to finish 4th at this level and distance. We were talking before we came on the air, Rowan Crichton's going to have a big day today, or we're going to be in big trouble.
Yeah, that's right. And everybody playing Beat the Expert will be too. But yeah, I really think he's got several live runners today. And the barn, clearly, as we've been mentioning the past couple of weeks, has really been in a good groove. But this gelding last time out, I thought, ran a good race, and really having his hand forced quite a bit from the outside post. I think that he's one that has a lot of natural early speed, and he wasn't able to clear and get over last time and was stuck kind of in that dueling, uncomfortable position. He also gets Paco Lopez up today, a more aggressive rider I think is going to fit him well.
Yeah, 3rd off the bench this afternoon. A horse I'm surprised you didn't have on top is the number 7, Vino.
I wanted to. I really wanted to.
For news to rivalry, we Coniston hip to dueling with him early and fading to finish 5th. But that was his first race back from a 2-month layoff.
It was. And anybody that knows me knows I'm a big wino. So that's why Ronnie is making fun of me, because I do love my Vino. But I almost put this one on top, but thinking Coniston just looked a little bit better on paper. But I'm in agreement with you. Great name for Mr. Amore Stable. And I thought that it was a fine race last time out, and we should see an improved effort today.
Well, the horse that we both have in 3rd sort of intrigues me in this race, mm-hmm. and that's the 8 More Mo. We moved to the Tammy Levy barn after the claim mix, made a 5-wide move to defeat 20 maidens going to mile 16th. I just think this horse ran really nice last time out. Tammy does a good job first off the claim.
Yeah, she does. First off the claim, though, with winners last time out, just 1 for 17 winning over the past 5 years, but 6 for 17 in the money. So she's able to keep those horses in good form, and she's just a very good horsewoman in general. So coming off of a good win, we'll see if he can step up and face winners.
Well, let's go to race 4. It's a 6-furlong sprint. These are maiden claimers, 3 and up, $35,000 to $25,000. And on top of your ticket, you do have the number 4, Cagliari.
I do, and we'll backtrack to the last race for this horse on February 10th. And this one, I thought, ran a good race that day. This was picking it up at the quarter pole. He was the number 3. Looks like he just had a lot of horse, and he's able to kind of ease out, and looks like in here he's not really going to do much of anything. But what I do like about him, and the short comment says steadied early, he was in a little bit tight. I didn't really see much of a steady, and I don't think it really hindered his race at all, but I thought that he finished up very, very nicely.
Yeah, I mean, it was a good performance, and he just, as you see, finished the 2nd to the 5 horse in here. I did go with the number 5 horse in here on top of my ticket, Grand Union. Drop it to the 35 level after encountering a little bit of early traffic, and it race finished 4th. That was going long, 5.5 furlongs. That was its $50,000 career debut. It was in the slot. Want to show you stat on Mr. Gilberto Zerpa. Second start for maiden claimers on the dirt. He's 9 for 22, 41%. He's in the money 68% of the time and a $2.73 return of investment. So Grand Union on top of my ticket.
Yeah, not a bad stat.
No, no,
it's
not at all.
Okay, you know. Yeah, I'm in agreement. This horse, I thought, really had a good workman-like race, and it's been 6 months since we've seen him, but that wasn't the slop. It was just his first race, and the barn clearly does such a great job and keeps him Isael Jaramillo in the saddle as well. But this is a really tricky race, I thought. The number one, Ocela Bye Bye, has speed and is taking a drop, and then Flash Gun is really, I think, the wild card, because this horse is moving to the barn of Todd Pletcher for the first time, taking a big drop in class. He was really all over the place and pulled up last time out, but that was off of a layoff. And anytime you see a horse now with the same owners, it's just a straight trainer change, but now with Todd Pletcher on the drop.
Yeah, and Luis Saez in the saddle today. And a horse that I had a little further down on my ticket. And, you know, I think that horse might be the one that's going to scare me in that particular spot.
Yeah, definitely a tricky race there for a compact field.
We're going to take a short break. And when we come back, I'll have my Rainbow Six ticket and maybe the Astronic Five ticket.
Oh.
Whether you're at home or at the track, have a stake in the race when you bet with ExpressBet. Sign up for an ExpressBet online betting account and receive up to a $500 sign-up bonus.
Welcome back to Gulfstream Today, Ron and Keisha. And as we mentioned at the top of the show, today is Friday, so we have the Stronic Five with the $100,000 guarantee. And let's show you that sequence.
Yeah, we do have a good sequence starting at Laurel Park in race number 9 over there. And then we have two races from Gulfstream Park in play and two races from Golden Gate in play. So around 5.07 p.m. will be the first post. And don't forget, you can always get those free past performances at gulfstreampark.com. If you're going to the window, ask for Laurel Race 9, and you can put your ticket in from there.
Well, we'll show you our combined ticket here. We got together and we worked on this together in our office.
We put our brains together.
Yeah, which is very scary, just saying that. And we come up with a $108 ticket. In Laurel Park, I think we got the logical three with the 2, 3, and 4 in that race. And Gulfstream Park, as we mentioned, our long shot in race number 9 is the 10 Modern Tail. So we both have that long shot today. Golden Gate has been one knocks me out every week.
Yeah, and I think so. And hopefully we're going to start it off with a price at Laurel, because we have the morning line favorite in Bunting, and Ron just loves Bunting anyway, so we had to use that horse. But then we have a 10-1 and a 15-1 in there, a 10-1 and a 6-1. So hopefully we get a little bit of a price in the first leg of Laurel. And I'm with you. Golden Gate has been very tricky. The horses that we used, I think, look like some of the logical ones and perhaps some of the shorter priced horses, but maybe those are the races that you want to have a little bit of coverage with.
Yeah, and maybe if you can find a race like at Gulfstream or Laurel that you can single somebody, can go deeper, because Golden Gate. If you go back and check all Astronic Five tickets, you'll see most people got knocked out with the Golden Gate fields, or at least in my case. I don't know about that. With that said, so that is our ticket, $108. Oh, but we're not done on Friday.
No.
We've got the Rainbow Six with $1.5 million in the pool. And here's my ticket. And guess what? $43.20. And I really like SPAC today. I don't know if you use SPAC on top of your ticket. That's my best bet of the afternoon. I also threw in General June. And as we mentioned, race number 9, got our long shot, Modern Tail. I don't know if we're going to get 10-1 on that horse. The rest of the progression as you go down, boy, I wish I could have a bigger ticket, because in race number 10, I don't know. I picked 2 and 5. We used that one in our Stronic Five ticket, but anything could happen in that race.
That's a very tricky race. You've got Starship Taxi that was beaten last time out, and then Rocky Strange coming off the layoff for Armando de la Cerda, and that's a very, very tricky cash out. I'm with the same two horses with you. In my estimation, race six was one of the most competitive races today, and that starts the pick five. I ended up using four in there, which we'll show in a few minutes, but I like your ticket, 43.20, and if we keep talking about Modern Tail, he won't be a long shot at all.
That's for sure. So let's go into, let's look at the race number five, if I can find it. And as I mentioned, I really like SPAC this afternoon to move to the Rohan Crichton Barn. And as we mentioned at the top of the show, he better have a good day or beat the expert. I will not do very well. And this one moved to his barn after the claim, responded to a drop down in competition, was four wide in that race, finished a third. But this barn really just recently 5 for 9 with recent claims. So doing a great job.
Yeah, been very impressive. Coniston was my best bet from a little bit earlier. Yeah. So we both have Rohan Crichton as the best bet. But this one had a outside post last time out, and I thought it was a very solid race for this filly. Now, first off the claim, and picking up Louis Sias as well, which I'm with you. But you can't, sometimes you just start to look through these races and you just can't get by Mike Maker, who does have General June, and taking a drop in class for this Street Boss filly.
Yeah, we'll show you stat on Mr. Mike Maker. Second career start, maiden claim is on the turf right here at Gulfstream Park. So we narrowed it down. He's 3 for 22, 14%, 36% in money, but he's got that positive return on investment. And you're exactly right. And you just saw my Rainbow Six ticket. SPAC is my best bet, but I couldn't leave General June off my ticket.
And just 3 for 22 in the win column there. But as you said, these are horses that will give you some value in your return on investment, which is always a plus. And this really got off to a poor start in her debut. She also didn't take money in her debut. So curious to see what we get from her second time out with Jose Ortiz in the saddle.
Yeah, and I have Rosa Star in third. You have it in fourth. We basically have almost the same super in there, and that is race number five. And now, of course, that is the start of the Rainbow Six. Race number six this afternoon, 1 mile starter optional claimer. These are 3 and up. They started for 50 or less, so they can be claimed for $50,000 in this spot. And this starts our late pick five.
Yeah, and I ended up using four horses. And sometimes you look at a race like this and you say, okay, well, I'm going to single the Jason Service horse in here. But I think that this is one that is going to have a little bit of a tougher time for that FedBiz cult. I thought that Math Wizard, first off the claim for Safi Joseph Jr., looked very, very interesting, just given the way he's won his last couple. Then you've got Joe DiBaggio and Gran Paraiso rematching. 7-3. I'm going to go 3 deep today, and my single is just going to come in race number 8 with Salt Pond. I really did like Richie's Sister, and that was going to be my potential single. With the scratch of that horse, I default into Salt Pond, who I think has got the speed and just the good recent form. 3 deep in race number 9. Surprise, surprise, that's our long shot, Modern Tail, in case you hadn't heard already. And then the same two horses that Ron used in the cash out for a $36 play.
Well, if there's one horse that's not named after me, it is the number 6 Math Wizard.
I thought you were going to say Bronze. I was like, you look pretty tan to me.
No. Math Wizard, this one moved to the Safi Joseph Jr. barn after the claim, followed a third place finish behind an undefeated horse called Maximum Security. Back-to-back open length victories. Status quo, they keep it with Jose Ortiz going for the hat trick today.
Yeah, he certainly is. Now, what's 2 plus 2?
4. Now I can
do. There you go. That's pretty good. Yeah, pretty good. But, I mean, I'm with you for sure. I think that this horse, first off the claim, does have to step up in class, but the last two races were just so impressive.
Well, we want to go back and show you a performance between, you mentioned Gran Paraiso and Joe DiBaggio. They had a pretty good race last time.
It really was. And as we look, this is a little bit early in the race, just highlighting the number 4, Gran Paraiso, because he gets totally steadied out of the race early on. And he's easy to spot in those yellow colors and just having to really kind of tap on the brakes under Emiseo Jaramillo. And what I think was most impressive about this, and he's been bumped back in the start of his last couple of races, is that he re-rallies so gamely. Joe DiBaggio was the 3. He was more forward throughout pretty much the entire race. And so there he is coming on the outside. And these two really game down to the wire. But I thought, given the trip that Gran Paraiso had, losing his position early, big performance from him. And he's a 2-time winner in this field.
Yeah, and with that said, I backed off. I have him in fourth, and I prefer Joe DiBaggio a little bit. But I know you have the number 1 Bronzed on top of your ticket.
I do. I ended up taking this one, and I believe you have a stat to show on this horse. But every stat that I looked up on Jason Service was just good with this kind of move. And had a big win last time out. You notice I used him on top, but I was not – totally sold on him.
Well, let's show you that stat on Jason Service. Maiden winner last out on the dirt. Just straight maiden winner last out on the dirt. He's 34%, 23 for 68, 63% in the money and a $2.19 return investment. I can understand why you might want to put him on top of your ticket.
And then even just narrowing that down, maiden winners last time out going from sprint to route, he's 8 for 14 for a 57% win average and a $5.15 ROI, which is what really pushed it over the edge for me. So like I said, no matter what kind of stat you end up looking, there's a lot of layers to this race, but sometimes when you try to get cute, it's right there in front of you.
Well, race number 7, a mild turf event for maiden claiming Philly's 3-year-olds, $20,000, and I did go with the number 6 Folly on top. I'll start it off, drop it to the 20 level, face tougher in our local turf outings for trainer Christophe Clement, Louis Saez. I think this horse needed the class relief for this spot.
I think so, too. Been running against significantly tougher. And she's the type of filly, I think, that has the ability to be involved in the race a little bit more early on and be a little bit more forward. That's where she was 2 starts back. Last time out, she was improving pretty well, actually. I think it's a better race than it looks on paper. So the class relief really should be good for her today. The number 1, Mia's Bobtail. A similar kind of horse, actually. We seem to be talking about these Rohan Crichton horses that look like they're in the right spot today and had the outside post last time, and that's exactly what happened with Mia's Bobtail. Given her natural speed and the inside post under Tyler Gaffalione, I think that she should get a really smooth trip today.
Yeah, I agree. I got that one in second behind Folly, but Mia's Bobtail, I couldn't leave off my ticket. A horse that you didn't use and I had some interest in is the horse not interested. This one moved to the edge of Keneally Bond after the claim, turned back to a mile, rallied to come within 3/4 of a length of finishing 4th. Mile in his 16th day. Eddie Keneally looked it up real quick, 9 for 25 recently, 36% with new claims. And I like the fact that Jose Ortiz is in the saddle. So a little bit of a shot there with the number 9, not interested.
I like it, and I'll take a shot with the number 3, Sing Song Bird, getting a drop and trying the turf for Mike Tomlinson.
Well, race number 8, as you mentioned earlier, a big scratch in here of the number 4, Richie's Sister, 8-5 on the morning line. This is a 5-furlong turf allowance, optional claimer for straight state-bred fillies and mares, 4 and up. You went with the 3, Salt Pond. I can understand. I went with All About Stella.
Yeah, and I just took Salt Pond in here because I actually really liked her quite a bit. Even before, yes, I had Richie's Sister on top, and I thought she'd be pretty tough to beat today. But Salt Pond, I think, has done some good running. She broke her maiden for 16. Broke her maiden at Laurel Park. She won the 16 non-winners of 2 a couple starts back and then was claimed for Mike Trombetta. And last time out, I think that even though she was the favorite, she was a little bit further back than she prefers to be. Given the fact that Javier Castellano is going to ride her today, she seems to be training very sharply, and the main pace scratch of Richie's Sister, I hope that she's really involved in the race early on.
Yeah, and All About Stella, solid in a defeat. She rallied 3 rides. She finished 2nd at this level in distance. It's Jenna Antonucci. The horse that we both have in 3rd, Valuable Package, showed a touch of class when this horse was 3rd in the Grade 3 Matron way back in 2017. But it's the daughter of Kenneth Harris. That's the intriguing one in that race. I don't know if those can run after that long layoff.
She really is. She hasn't run in about 15 months. It was December of 2017 at Tampa and the Sandpiper that we last saw her with a really high-quality field. And she's faced some good horses in her short career, but she's a 4-year-old filly coming in off that big layoff.
Well, race 9 this afternoon, a 5-furlong sprint. These on the turf claim is 4 and up, $16,000. Oh, gee, who do you have on top?
I don't know. Who do you have in your top 4? Because we seem to agree. Somebody was peeking at the picks, I guess.
Yeah, so Modern Tail, we mentioned a bunch of times. Best closer in the field, breaks from the outside, sits the trip.
You know what? This poor horse has got a lot of weight to carry today, but we'll show you the last race for this horse and Sleeping Giant, who also comes out of that same race. And 2 very, very different trips. I thought they both ran well. Sleeping Giant, the number 9 in the red cap to the outside, whereas Modern Tail's in the green cap way towards the back, and he looks totally out of the race right now. Sleeping Giant, however, was dueling the entire time and never had a breather and was very, very game to hold on. Now is where you want to look at that green cap with Modern Tail and the momentum that he has coming late to get up and finish in the money there, I thought was really impressive.
And I saw a lot of speed in the race, and I think it just sets up perfectly for him. Now the number 9, Dance Proudly, who we just mentioned, is back making his first start since rewarding his back is with that 3-5 favorite at this level of distance back in December. So we'll show you a stat on Jorge Navarro. Winner last time out. coming back from a 61 to 180 day layoff on the turf. He's 7 for 20, 35%, 40% in the money, and a positive return on investment. So good numbers there. Sleeping Giant, you just saw how well that horse ran. Mm-hmm. And Tenacity Zip is the one that if I could have gone four deep, that's the one I would have used.
I'm with you, and a great stat there. And I know you were off yesterday, but did you get a chance to see Starship Reina's performance yesterday?
No, I did, yes. Actually,
she won, just so impressive with how she's won. So certainly the bar has been on a roll, and Dance Proudly coming in off a freshening, but a very good win last time out.
Well, the 10th and final race on the Friday card is 6 furlong maiden claimer for 3 and up, 12-5. And I went with the number 5, Starship Taxi. Is the logical choice, I think, to deliver in the nightcap after just getting beat a nose at this level and distance. Steve Gwoskin, Miguel Vasquez in the saddle. And you, I know, had Rocky Strange on top of your ticket.
I did. Well, I really liked Starship Taxi at 5-1 last time out, and he got beat a nose. So I think I'm still a little bit salty about it. So the number 2, Rocky Strange, was a horse I've always been a fan of. I like him sprinting. I like him at this level. He's 0 for 14, but he's been off the layoff, and he's just been the type of horse that's been really tough to figure out. He looked like he had a lot of promise, so hopefully today's the day.
Well, that's how we see the card today, Friday. And, of course, we got the Stronic 5. We got the Rainbow 6 at $1.5 million. We got our buddy Pete Aiello coming up in just a couple of moments with scratches and changes. And we didn't laugh through the whole show.
No, we made it through, which is always a plus. So thanks for joining us today at Gulfstream Park. Don't worry, there's plenty more opportunities for us.